Hi, my name is Sydney Fabregas. I'm a principal artist at Heartland Sings, and this is going to be a short series based on my vocal arts workshop, Acting While Singing. All right, part three, basic information. So you've gotten your song or you've gotten cast in a role. Now you need to learn about the person you are portraying. You can find a lot of this information from inside the story or from reference material such as source material or papers that people have written about the show you're doing. Starting off, you want to know your character's name, their age, and basic information about them, like their posture, their walk, how they speak, how they sing, do they have any distinguishing marks, and an overall description of what they look like. This is really focused on the external, not the internal quite yet. Then you want to delve into their occupation, their interests, their beliefs, and their ambitions, and how they navigate through the story using them. You also want to establish where they're from and their familial slash friend relationships. So these are the people that they're around, if they're around anyone at all. If it's family, you want to make sure you know who their parents are, what their parents do, if they have any siblings, what those siblings do, and if they have any close friends, what the close friends do. How are they involved in the story around your character? Then you get to have a little more fun with their personality. Try to pick out what you think their favorite color is. You can reference something within the show or what their favorite food is. Again, a reference within the show. Do they like music? Do they like a specific kind of music or a specific kind of artist? Do they have a favorite song? If they read, what would be some of their favorite books, or would they like certain TV shows? You can answer within the context of the story, or you can bring some more modern answers in just so you can feel a bit more connected to the character that way. Now that you've connected some modern references, you can connect how this character is similar to you and how they're different from you. I like to write a paragraph for each of those questions just so I can really flesh them out, because I'm not similar to a lot of the characters I've portrayed, but I am similar to some. So I want to make sure I have a distinction between the two. Then you want to establish your relationships with other characters in the play and how they impact you. How do these characters feel about your character? How does your character feel about them? Does it drive the plot forward? In what way? Lastly, we're going to be looking at the tried and true Stanislavski method. We're going to look for our super objective, which is our character's objective for the entire play. And then you want to locate your objective, which is what your character wants within a scene or a song. So if you're looking at a specific song, your objective is within that. With any song, try to keep your objective to one sentence. You don't want to get it muddled and long. For every objective, there is an obstacle. So your super obstacle is the show's most significant internal and external conflict for your character. But your obstacle is what can be overcome within a scene or a song. Lastly, your tactics are strategies you use to overcome the obstacles and obtain your objective. You always want to voice these as two. So my tactic is to overwhelm my enemies. My tactic is to find my phone. Again, this is from my Acting While Singing workshop. If you are at all interested in knowing what Heartland Sings is up to, please check out heartlandsings.org/events.